welcome me back to the Sweet Searchy Podcast. Now that we talked about Kobe Bryant's tribute, let's dive into the show that we was going to do. The Royal Rumble match and the recap. I got the pleasure to watch it tonight. I don't have to say the show was good. The only bad part of the show was the women's, because she had Charlotte Flair winning. Whoopie-doo. Charlotte Flair always wins, because that's what the WWE wants. Has her versus Becky Lynch for a long time. You don't get somebody fresh, like Shayna Baszler. Nope, it has to be Charlotte Flair, because you're a Flair, and Flair is good for the business. It can't be nobody else, but... Anyways, so the first match that I didn't get to see because it was on the pre-show. Sheamus, like as I predicted, Shorty G. Adonis beat Abiro. And then the third match, when the show kicked off, we had Roman Reigns beat King Corbin. I guess it's Charlotte Flair won. That was really interesting. I really thought Nia Jax was going to be coming back, but nope. But I predicted that Tamina and Naomi would be in the match. Did not see Beth Phoenix coming back, but Beth Phoenix really put out a good outing. And then the next match was Bayley versus Lacey Evans. Bayley beat Lacey Evans. The Fiend beat Daniel Bryan. Becky Lynch beat to retain. She beat Oxa. And then the final match. The final match was the Royal Rumble match, which was a very, very fun to watch. It was crappy in the beginning because they had Brock Lesnar. Let's really dive into this real quick. But before we even dive into the men's, let's talk about the women's. Number one was Alexa Bliss. She got eliminated by Bianca Belair. Bianca Belair had a really good showing in that match. She did wonderful. I have to say she did really good. That was just impressive. She got eliminated by Charlotte Flair. Mighty Molly Holly came back. She got eliminated by Bianca Belair. Nikki Cross came in at number 4. Got eliminated by Bianca Belair. Alana got eliminated by Liv Morgan. Liv Morgan got eliminated by Lana. Mercedes Martinez, wow, she dominated the match. She got eliminated by Mandy Rhodes and Sonya Deville. Speaking of some Mandy Rhodes and Sonya Deville, they both got eliminated by Bianca Belair. Otis can save the day, which Otis is a funny guy. I think Otis and Mandy should hook up. Candice LeRae got eliminated. She was number 9. So Mandy was number 8. Then Candice LeRae, she got eliminated by Bianca Belair, Sonya Deville. And then number 11, you had Kairi Sane, met her. Then number 12 was Mia Hamm. Number 13 was Dana Brooke. Number 14 was Tamina. Number 15 was Dakota Kai. Number 16 was Chelsea Green. And number 17, new winner, Charlotte Flair. Number 18, Naomi. Number 19, Beth Phoenix. Toni Storm was number 20. 21 was Kelly Kelly. 22 was Sarah Logan. Number 23 was Natalya. 24 was Isaiah Lee. Number 25 was Zayna Vega. Number 26, Shotty Blackheart. Number 27, Carmella. Tianox was 28. And then Santina. That was funny. She came back, but she eliminated herself. Shayna Baszler got eliminated. But man, she should have won that one. Shayna should have been Shayna versus Becky Lynch. We may still see that match. You never know. And now in the men's match, we have Brock Lesnar, number 1, which was annoying, because he just goes in and eliminated everybody up until Drew McIntyre got him. And then we had Elias, then we had Eric Rowan, and so Elias was number 2. Number 3 was Eric Rowan. Then Robert Roode was number 4. John Morrison, I thought he would have a good showing, but nope. Quickly got eliminated by Brock Lesnar, the bitch-ass Brock Lesnar. Number 5 was Kofi Kingston. Number 7 was Rey Mysterio. Number 8 was Big E. Number 9 was Cesaro. Number 10 was Shelton Benjamin. That was a funny thing, but Brock Lesnar turned on you. Shin Nakamura was number 11. MVP was number 12. Keith Lee was number 13, which I thought he could have a good performance, but nope, Brock Lesnar took him out. Number 14 was Braun Strowman. Number 15 was Ricochet. But it was speaking of MVP. It was good to see him good, but it only lasted not so long. And then number 16 was Drew McIntyre. Number 17 was Drew The Miz. Number 18 was AJ Styles. Number 19 was Dolph Ziggler. Number 20 was Carl Anderson. Number 21, surprise, surprise, Edge. And I was pumped up and fired up when I saw Edge. I was so happy. And then number 22 was King Corbin. Number 23, Matt Riddle. Number 24, Luke Gallows. Number 25, Randy Orton. Number 26, Roman Reigns. Number 27, Kevin Owens. Number 28, Aleister Black. Number 29, Samoa Joe. And number Seth Rollins was number 30, who had his little buddies, and they took out Samoa Joe, Aleister Black, and Kevin Owens. But those guys came back and beat the shit out of him and took him to the back. And then he came it down to the top three, and then Randy Orton got eliminated by Edge. So it was funny, like, working together, and you know, hey, turn on you, but this is the Royal Rumble, guys, you know. And then we had Roman Reigns versus eliminated Edge. So it came down to Roman Reigns, and Drew McIntyre, and the winner of the Royal Rumble is... Drew McIntyre is now on his way to WrestleMania to face, you know who, Brock Lesnar. Me and Javon will be there watching Drew McIntyre win the title. My thoughts on Drew McIntyre, I don't really care. I'm glad it wasn't Brock Lesnar or anybody else, but I'm glad Drew McIntyre won because now he'll go in there and he will be the new WWE champion. And my buddy Javon would say, I'm so happy that somebody else, and not Roman Reigns or anybody else, it's finally somebody else new. Congratulations, Drew McIntyre. I can't wait to see WrestleMania kick Brock Lesnar's ass. You know how I feel about Brock Lesnar and Javon. Let's pull out. Where do we go from here? I think we might see Edge and Randy Orton team up at WrestleMania. Hopefully they can take on the OC. If we can get a six-man tag team champion right there, six-man championship match between Edge, Orton, and somebody else versus AJ Styles or the OC. That would be a good match. We're going to see Roman Reigns find a way to get in that match against The Fiend. We'll see Charlotte Flair. Hopefully Shayna Baszler gets in there versus Becky Lynch. Maybe Lacey Evans will win the title at WrestleMania. For the U.S., maybe we'll have Rey Mysterio or Humberto Carrillo. But NIT or Intercontinental, I think we might see Braun Strowman win that title. One tag team, it might be the return of the Iconics. What else in this match? And then, those are my WrestleMania predictions, but we have a long way to go to WrestleMania. Well, you know, we gotta create those matchups. So we will see what happens down here. Now, this is the beginning of WrestleMania. This is the fun season. So here we go. Royal Rumble to me, ladies and gentlemen, guys, was very off the chart, was good until the women's match. So, you know, at the end of the day, but that's whatever. It's whatever. I really don't care. That's how you want to take it. If it'll be, that's cool. Like I said, the program was fun to watch. And now that's over with, we get ready for WrestleMania. We follow up. What's going to happen on Raw tomorrow? We know we're going to follow up with Seth Rollins and his little buddies and Kevin Owens' story. We will have the Drew McIntyre. Probably kick off the show with Drew McIntyre choosing Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar is going to be pissed off, but who gives a shit? I'm really happy that they're setting up McIntyre for a big push, because he deserves it. He doesn't need to be a mid card anymore. I'm sorry, but Drew McIntyre is now, and he's going to win the title, and he's going to be the new WWE champion. Brock Lesnar, you part-time champion. You need to go retire, buddy. Go somewhere else. No, go to UFC. Go win championships there. Part-time championship champion. You need to go somewhere. You need a guy like Drew McIntyre to hold the title. So, I mean, it's McIntyre's time. He has been a champion before. He was in Impact. He was in Impact Wrestling. And he has been a world their champion, then came back to WWE, and he's been an NXT champion. So McIntyre's time is now, and let's get it. It's time for him to get the biggest push, and I can't wait for WrestleMania, because I'm going to scream my head off. And yes, we will be having a WrestleMania recap show with my thoughts, so I'm very, very excited. I think tonight, we saw Roman Reigns, but you know, the guy got tired, you know, after competing in the beginning, but you know, it's not Roman Reigns this time. He will be WWE champion, that's my prediction. It's McIntyre's time. So ladies and gentlemen, now that we are set, this is the road to WrestleMania. It's been a pleasure to talk to you guys about WWE here on Battle Royal Rumble. This is just, like I said, we kicked off with my buddy Johan. We just keep getting better here, because it's going to get juicy. It's going to get juicy, yo. Juicy, juicy, juicy. Because it's going to get a little bit spicy. Spicy. For the road to WrestleMania. I'm telling you, brother, Hulkamania, Sturtmania, Strange and Javon Mania, and Kleptomania will be running wild in Tampa, and you better do that. Ooh, yeah, baby. Get ready for a showdown, because it's about to go down. Tomorrow, we got a minute left. I may just be signing off with some final thoughts of the day. Was like I said, final thoughts of the day was up and down. Just with Kobe Bryant passing away, but the big sad, and then just the whole wrestling. Tomorrow show. Actually, no, you won't hear from me until probably Wednesday, when we do a Super Bowl preview show, and because we're going to get some interviews from both sides. Because when they have their media night, we want to hear what Chiefs are saying, especially Emmanuel Sanders and Patrick Mahomes about the big game coming up on Sunday. So until then, guys, you all enjoy your week, and we will talk to you Wednesday. Wednesday it is. Play me out. Yo, DJ. Pull me out. Yo, DJ. Send me out with some song. DJ. Go, DJ. Doodles.